Before proceeding to the creation and updation of the template, let us create card type element for rendering account types. So first let us understand what is this card type element and what is the utility of this. So if you could see here the radio buttons which are displayed for each of these account types which are available is actually encapsulated in the form of a card type element. So the idea is that a card type element will be passed on an instance of the current account types information fetched from a API call dynamically, and so that in case there are new types of accounts which are added, that gets automatically rendered. So instead of taking the route of hard coding it, what we are doing is we are actually creating a card type element whose gets an instance values, and then that will be rendered as part of this element. So as you can imagine, that the card type element will be instantiated in the account form.html with the current values of the account type model, which are dynamically fetched and then binded from the API calls. And the second part of this template would be to answer this question: do you have any preferred branch? Once this user clicks yes here, it will be populated with a list of current branches, and the user will be able to click one of the branches, and then the user will be able to do that setting of preferred branch. So this is how this particular option works. Having understood the need for card type element, now let us proceed to the activity of coding it. So we are back in the Visual Studio Code, and let me head to this SRC folder and then create a new file called card-type.html. So this is the place where we will be building the card type. So let us get started with the coding of card type. So therefore the DOM module is specified here with the ID to be card type here, and this has got a template, and there's a script here where you are calling this polymer function, and then the element is getting registered here. And this particular element requires two properties. One is card, which is of type object, and the second is whether it is checked value. So therefore this is a boolean type. Now we need to write two more things. One is we need to write the styling for this, and the second one would be the renderable markup with respect to the card type. So let us first proceed with the styling. So these are the styles which are mentioned as part of this. So there is a styling available for host as well as paper radio buttons. So there are different styles which are included along with this deep synchronizer. The next thing that we do is to get the card type information done, which is the markup. So as you can see here, there is a div class called card name which is being added here, and you could see that there is a paper radio button which is being instantiated here. And also observe that there is a data binding which is happening with respect to the card.code here, which means to say that any element or any other part of this application which is instantiating this card type will take the responsibility of providing a card instance so that these values will get rendered here. So therefore so you have a menu title here, with the, that's where you are printing the description, and then you are printing the long description and then detailed description. So which means to say that any other element which is instantiating this, it will set up a DOM repeat, and as part of that it will keep on sending one instance of account instance, so that that gets constructed, and then a radio button will get rendered. So this is how this is going to work.